Good morning, everyone. Yes, how are you all? I hope everybody is fine. Okay, so we have learned the beautiful chapter. What was the title of our chapter? Yes, Black Beauty. A wonderful story of a horse. Very good. So I have given you one task in the last class. Do you remember? Yes. It was to underline the difficult words in the story. So I hope you all have underlined. Yes? Okay. Now we can discuss the new words or the difficult words in the chapter. Are you ready? Yes. Very good. So let's see the words. Yeah. The first word is coats. COLT, coats, and the meaning, a young male horse, in particular one less than 4 years old. A young male horse, in particular one less than 4 years old. Clear? Yes. Now the second word is gallop. Gallop. GALLOP, gallop, which means the fastest speed of a horse with all the feet of the ground together in each walk. The fastest speed of a horse with all the feet of the ground together in each walk. Clear? Yes. Now the third one is ploughboy. Who was our ploughboy? Yes. Dick. Dick was his name. And the meaning of the word ploughboy, a boy who guides the animals drawing a plough. A boy who guides the animals drawing a plough. Clear? Yes. Now, the fourth one is hedges. The fourth one is hedges, which means a fence or boundary formed by closely growing bushes or shrubs. A fence or boundary formed by closely growing bushes or shrubs. Clear? Now, we can go to the fourth one. Sorry, the fifth one. The fifth one is twigs, which means a small thin branch of a tree or a bush. A small thin branch of a tree or a bush. Okay? Yes. Now the sixth one is grazed. Sixth one is graze, which means eat grass in a field. Eat grass in a field. Okay? Yes. Now the seventh one is meadow. And the meaning of the word meadow is a piece of grassland. A piece of grassland. Now, we can go to the eighth one. And that is bread. B-R-E-D. B-R-E-D. It is the past form of breed. It is a past form of breed, which means to give birth. To give birth. Okay. Now, the ninth word is that startled, which means surprised. Okay. Startled, which means surprised. Now, we can go to the tenth word, and that is saddle.
Saddle, 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 which means a seat fastened on the back of a horse for riding, typically made of leather and raised at different and rear. A seat fastened on the back of a horse for riding, typically made of leather and raised at the front and rear. Clear? Yes. Now we can move into the 11th one. And the 11th word is bridle. And the meaning of the word bridle is the headgear used to control a horse consisting of buckle straps. The headgear used to control a horse consisting of buckled straps. Okay? Yes. Now, we can go to the 12th one. That is trot. Trot. T-R-O-T. Which means run at a moderate speed with short steps. Run at a moderate speed with short steps we can call trots. Okay? Yes. Now, the 13th word is chase. C-H-A-I-S-E. Chase. Which means an open horse-drawn carriage for one or two people, usually with one horse and two wheels. I'll repeat once again here. The meaning of the chase is an open horse-drawn carriage for one or two people, usually with one horse and two wheels. Clear? Yes. Now, the 14th word is harness. H-A-R-N-E-S-S. Harness. Which means a set of straps and fittings by which a horse is fastened to a cart, plow, etc. and is controlled by its driver. A set of straps and fittings by which a horse is fastened to a cart, plow, etc. and is controlled by its driver. Okay? Now, the last word is that neigh. Neigh. N-E-I-G-H. Neigh. Which means the cry of a horse. The cry of a horse. Clear? So here we discussed 15 words and its meanings. Clear? Yes. Now, you should learn all these words and their meanings and copy onto your English notebook. Okay? Yes. One time is enough. Huh? And you should read the words many times and you should learn and comprehend it. Okay? So, I hope you all understood the words and their meanings. And we will discuss the question answers in the coming classes. So, we can stop here now. Take care. Bye.